Sports. It's in the game.
We attacking, better stand back and watch a run. Shotgun come with the option. Send big blitz, nobody blocking. Big win, that's a ring and a watch. Strong in when he come in the slot. Trying to bend the corner, your limbs getting. That's your partner, then your twin game. All you want to do is talk, I don't need talk.
Gotta hurry, somebody talk.
I can pull up with that, Chewbacca that. Banging my chest and my head on the lock. Feeling like walk a flock of flame. I put the opposition out the game. I'm out of the pocket, but I rock with the game.
We attacking, better stand back and watch a run. Shotgun come with the option. Send big blitz, nobody blocking. Big win, that's a ring and a watch. Strong in when he come in the slot. Trying to bend the corner, your limbs getting. That's your partner, then your twin game.
Tables and turn. Forget the bridge we done built. This time I let them all burn.
They tried to count me out.
Well, now it's the word.
I bring it paper, paper, paper from the first to the first.
They count me out.
Yeah, yeah.
Now count me in. Oh, I'm hot. Sizzling.
Oh,
they count me out.
Nah, nah.
It all begins.
Right here.
Right now. Catch me if you can.
Total catch up.
But I still can't even see them from the view. Got my check up. And now I'm trying to blow a bag of two. Proud of shoot. And all this drink get what I desire. Put him out, what I told him, cause that boy he on fire.
Walk in that thing and air it up, been in my bag a little bit.
Remember my pockets in a jar, I couldn't build a little chick.
They say that Trini left his paper.
You see that's a mill. Why you catch all my brothers ballin', ain't shooting no bricks.
Hold up, check me out.
Hold up.
I think the tables and turn.
Forget the bridge we done built, this time I let them all burn.
They tried to count me out.
Well, now it's the word.
I bring it paper, paper, paper from the first to the first.
They count me out.
Yeah, yeah.
Now count me in. Oh, I'm hot. Sizzling.
Oh,
don't count me out.
Nah, nah.
It all begins.
Right here.
Right now. Catch me if you can. Never really care what they say.
On God.
Only ever care about one thing.
Ching, ching, ching.
Cha-chain, cha-chain. Rack A's, rack A's.
Hit the bank.
Ba-bang, ba-bang. Put you in your play. Wait, they done got me started. Without me, it's not a party.
The NFL on EA Sports is in the great state of Tennessee at Nissan Stadium here in Nashville. The whole of downtown Nashville likely still reverberating with the sounds of the Titans taking the field a moment ago. They're ready for football as their Titans are set to match up with the Cincinnati Bengals. Here's Randy Bullock now to put toe to leather, and off we go from Nashville. And here comes a return from a few steps into the end zone. And this return will net positive as he gets past the 25 and up to the 27-yard line. Former second-round pick, this is Joe Mixon. And that's not the start that he was looking for, as he's going to be met and dropped behind the line. On second and 11 now. Burrow, throw left side, complete to Chase. He's at the 50, 30, 10, and all the way in for a Cincinnati score. Jamar Chase, 74 yards. And the Bengals on just two plays have taken the lead. Extra point by McPherson, up and good. And that makes the score 7-0. After the touchdown, McPherson on to kick this one away. They'll elect to bring it out here from the end zone. And no chance to get away as they'll get him down at about the 17-yard line. Tannehill and the Titans come up now first and 10 at their own 17-yard line. The first carry for Jeremy McNichols. And he goes across the 20 to the 22. Von Bell up to make the tackle. On the ground, this is McNichols. And he is met quickly in the backfield. Down he goes, folded like a lawn chair. That's a big loss of three, and it brings up third down. And that one goes incomplete on the drop. That's one he definitely normally catches. Fourth down. So the defense able to get off the field here on third down.
And it's one of the goals of the game. They've got to be effective on passing downs. It's one of the few things defenses chart. How did we do on third down? That's a nice start for them in this one.
Got his man. That's the Pro Bowler, Julio Jones. So first and 10 now from the 30. Now it's McNichols. And tough going there as he'll only get it up to about the 31. The run only got a yard. Here's second and 9. Now it's Tannehill. And that one off the mark behind him. Incomplete. Charles already trailing by a touchdown early. This offense, how imperative is it for them to get points out of this drive?
Well, they feel like they have to go ahead and match because of what was already on the board against their defense. But I think even more so, you just want to avoid three and outs. You want to be able to stay on the field for a little while, let your defense catch their breath a little bit, even if you don't score any points.
And that is incomplete. Oh, he had a defender right there with him to force that to the ground. And fourth down now coming up.
And that's exactly what defenses talk about. You've got to find ways to get off the field when you can, especially on third down. And third down defense going to be vital in this game. Able to knock that one away and force a fourth down.
Oh, a big decision here early. Look at this. They're going to go for it on their own side of the field. They snap it to Tannehill. On the slant, he'll get it to Jones. And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line. On first and 10, Tannehill. He rifles one that's intercepted. Picked up by Jesse Bates. And the return stops at the 39-yard line.
Well, that's a drive killer right there. Not a really confident throw either. This one was kind of up for grabs, and it's going to come down to the hands of the wrong team.
Throwing now, Burrow on first down. That one taken in by T. Higgins. And he works it past the 30, almost to the 25.
Someone sharp in this game. I mean, a touchdown pass in the first drive. It comes right back, and he's flinging it around really well here.
A really nice throw there to pick up the first down. You kind of just feel a laser focus and confidence about him, and I think we saw that this week, didn't we? Talking to him and the coaches, they felt good about his performance coming up.
Yeah, I was really impressed with that last practice we saw. When they went through two-minute drill, when they went through all the different situations, ball hardly hit the ground, and I thought, yeah, he might be locked in for this one.
Second down and 4. Burrow. And this throw incomplete. And the defender all over him that time, and it's going to lead to third down. Now they face a third down and 4 after that incompletion on second down. Burrow now off the bootleg. Toward the sideline. Did he keep the feet in? Yes, he got them both down, says the side judge. And that's good enough for a first down. Play clock winding down, a whistle, and possibly a false start. That false start knocks them back behind the 10 now as they'll try again, first and goal. After the penalty, it's Mixon. He'll get 2 out of that run, and it's going to bring up a second and goal. Still a ways from the end zone as they come up now on second and goal. Now it's Burrow. Trying to get it to Chase, but it's intercepted. Picked off inside the 5. And a short return will be stopped inside the 10 at the 8-yard line. Charles, not only is that an interception, it's one when you were really knocking on the door for a touchdown inside the red zone.
You're actually thinking points. No matter what, at worst, you're thinking kicking a field goal and getting three. We might look back on this in the second half and say, you remember when they didn't get points on that drive? This could cost them.
After one, 7-0 on EA Sports. Now it's 2nd and 9. From the gun, here's Tannehill. And he's going to go down right near the goal line. The officials look at each other. They're going to mark him at the 1 yard line. After the sack, they'll come up now 3rd and long.
Yeah, I wouldn't be surprised to see them run the ball here just to try and get some space.
Well, he tries to force it in, and it's intercepted. Picked up by Jesse Bates, and he will bring it back. It's a pick six for a Bengals TD.
Did I just see what I thought I saw? Did I just see what I thought? That had to be. Come on, say it for me. Say it for me. Who picked up that pass?
The free safety.
Oh, you got to have those great skills back there. Eyes, anticipation, great hands. And, of course, how about the fluid moves afterwards to take it all the way to the house?
Sounds like you're watching your old game film up here in your head.
Yeah, that's the dream I had of being that player. I just never was.
And we'll see a return here from the end zone. And he'll be brought down at the 28-yard line, so the decision to bring it out of the end zone gets him three more. The Titans offense set to begin the drive. And job one here, Charles, just keep possession of the football. Two drives, two turnovers to this point.
You're exactly right, Doctor. Hippocratic oath. First, do no harm. And right now, they're harming themselves on offense.
I like that. No one is mistaking me for a doctor, though. But thank you, Dr. Davis.
Throwing on 2nd and 14. Tannehill. And this is going to be caught, but they'll say out of bounds. So it's incomplete.
This defense has been very disruptive early on as they force another one to go awry.
Seems to be the front and the back end. Pass rush, they've been able to get home, and they're taking the ball away in coverage as well.
I love how you put it together. The front and back working in sync, only way to play good defense. Here we go, D.
Here I come again. Now on 3rd and long, they'll look to throw. And now he lost the football. Tannehill loses it.
Offensively lucky there, able to keep the football, but now 4th down, so they'll have to boot it away.
I do think, though, they're going to look at this as a positive. One, they recovered the fumble, so they retained possession. But two, being able to punt it changes field position for them. Imagine if that turnover takes place there. Now your defense has to go onto the field and try and hold. Instead, they get a little breathing room.
Now the Bengals going to use the first of their timeouts. They'll have two remaining as we step aside here in this 2nd quarter. And this offense has converted twice already here in this first half on 4th down conversions. And here we go again. They are going for it. It's Tannehill. And it's incomplete. They cannot convert, and they turn it over. A surprising move to go for it. Predictably, at least somewhat predictably, it doesn't pay off. And boy, possession here turns over with a football already being in the red zone. Trying to shake off the interception. He'll look to throw. Oh, that's into double coverage and intercepted. Picked off at the 15, and he's going to get this one back to the 20-yard line.
Boy, that's the kind of interception that can save a game right there. They're already down 2 scores. Huge play, slowing down what was going against them.
I was thinking the same thing. You get down 3 scores there at this stage, could be in for a long ball game.
After the interception, here's Tannehill. Oh,
hit as he throws there, incomplete.
To this point, I've been impressed with the work defensively. They have not allowed a lot of receivers to run free. And there's another example, another incompletion.
Back to the air, Tannehill on second down. And for the third time here in this half, it's intercepted. Picked up by Jesse Bates. And he'll get this back to the 32-yard line. Yes, folks, that is his third interception, and I'm going to use one of the most overused phrases in football. He's a ball-hawking safety.
I love the way that you called for the shot there. That's perfect, though, because there is something to that. Being a safety often allows you freedom to roam around the defense, maybe not a specific assignment. Today, his assignment, find the football, and he's done so quite well.
Throwing on second and long, Burrow. Open man is Chase, complete. The Titans going to use the first of their timeouts. They'll have two remaining as we step aside here in this second quarter. The chance of wasting this great starting field position, a real threat. This is third and long. From the shotgun, Joe Burrow. This goes out wide for Mixon. Now Tennessee going to use the second of their timeouts. That's their second, so they'll have one remaining here in this second quarter. We'll be right back. Fourth and goal, and down by a touchdown, the offense stays on the field. Burrow going for it on fourth. Well, I'm not sure he saw the linebacker there, as that's batted down and incomplete. The Bengals try it, but it doesn't work out. And as a result, it'll be Titan football on the turnover on downs. Tennessee offense about set and ready to go. They'll start on the ground with McNichols. And boy, this defense again really making things tough on him as they stop him for no gain. 2 minutes to play, first half. It's 14 to nothing. Now the Titans will use their third and final timeout. And with halftime on the horizon, they'll be out of timeouts from here forward. A reminder that when halftime rolls around, Jonathan Coachman will have all the highlights and analysis of this first half of play from our studios in Orlando. Out of the gun, Tannehill. Man open, that's Chester Rogers. And they've got it well across midfield, down to the 40 before it's all said and done. On first down, it's Tannehill. And his pass is intercepted for the fourth time today. Picked off by the former first-rounder, Trey Waynes. And the Bengals are going to get the football here as he gets this up to the 38-yard line. Well, we heard all week that they were going to put the football in the air a lot. The problem is that is now four interceptions, Charles, that he has thrown in this first half. How do you treat a situation? What do you say to your quarterback right now?
Boy, that's an interesting question because a lot of it depends on the head coach and the people making the decisions. You have to know your quarterback and know if he's mentally tough enough to have a chance to turn it around. Or is he a guy that maybe you've seen enough and it's time to go to the backup? But right now what you're rooting for is your defense to help keep you in the game, to give him an opportunity to get back on track.
And that falls to the ground incomplete. A nice job of bodying him up defensively, and now it brings up third down. So the incomplete pass on the last play, and that leads us to a third and three. Out of the gun, it's Burrow. To Mixon on the check down. And he is going to have a Bengals first down by a couple of yards as they're able to convert here on third and three. The Bengals going to use the second of their timeouts as they get the stoppage with a little over 50 seconds to go in the first half. From midfield now, Burrow. Oh, he'll let one go deep for Higgins. And that is incomplete.
I think he's got to be careful not to force anything into coverage right there. There weren't really any throwing lanes. But the best part for him, he's got second and third down to fall back on.
Again, it's Burrow. Got a man open. It's Chase. And some space here. And he goes down, but not before getting this inside the 25. Now the Bengals going to signal for their third and final timeout as they stop it here with just under 40 ticks to go in this first half. Burrow going to fake to mix it and now look to throw. And now Burrow going to be intercepted yet again. Picked off inside the 10. And a big turnover there as his guys will get the football back. And that now two interceptions thrown in the second quarter.
And you know, a lot of people look at these guys and they think to themselves that maybe, possibly, they're still thinking about the first one. And they probably are. I think in this case, he's just trying to atone for the first interception. Tried a little bit too hard, maybe forced it a bit, and instead created a second one.
Trying to shake off the interception from the last drive. He'll look to throw. High throw, but the catch is made. And able to get it across the 20 before they get to him. On first down, Tannehill. And a high throw there as this is knocked away down to the ground and incomplete.
So many times when we talk about coverage, we're just about a defender running with a receiver, but a big part of it is understanding where the football is, finding it. In this case, when it arrived, it wasn't a surprise, and he was able to bat it away.
And some room to maneuver. The 40. The 20. And he's in for the touchdown on the final play of the first half. The prayer is answered.
How did they get that done?
The way this one was going, you just got the sense they needed something before half. They